गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल सॉल्व फ्यू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द चैप्टर डिटरमिनेंट। ऑलरेडी वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द एलिमेंट्री ऑपरेशंस, सो हियर वी विल सी हाउ टू अप्लाई दिस एलिमेंट्री ऑपरेशन टू सॉल्व डिटरमिनेंट विदाउट एक्सपेंडिंग। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इवेल्युएट determinant the value of this determinant you have to find. Now check, all the numbers are very large in this determinant. So first we have to simplify, we have to apply few row or column operation to make this number very small. So let determinant is equals to this 265, 240, 219, 240, 225, 198, 219, 198, 181. Now here if we apply C1 minus C3 and C2 minus C3, we check the elements of C1 and C2, these are larger than this C3. So if we apply here, C1 we are changing C1 minus C3, and C2 we are changing C2 minus C3. So 265 minus 219, that is 46. 240 minus 219, 21. C3 remains same, 219, 198 and 181. This remains same. 240 minus 198, that is 42. 219 minus 181, so here it will come 19 and here 19, 38. 225 minus 119, that is 27. And 198 minus 181, that is 17. So this we have. Now see that this column 3, it is really very large. So this column 3 also we have to simplify, we have to make small. Now here column 2 is smaller than column 1 and column 3. Column 2's elements are smaller than 1 and 3. So we will use column 2. So column 1 we are changing C1 minus 2C2, and C3 we are changing C3 minus, if we apply 10C2 then it will come 46 minus 42, that is 4. 42 minus 54, that is minus 12. 38 minus 34, that is 4. 21, 27, 17. 219 minus 210, so 9. 198 minus 270, that is minus 72, and 181 minus 170, that is 11. Okay, understood? Next, what we have to do, let's see, if we apply here R1 minus R3, so this element will become 0, and if we apply R2 plus 3R3, this will be 0. We have to make maximum number of 0 in any row and any column. So R1 we are changing like this, R1 minus R3 and R2 plus 3R3. So it will become 0, 4, minus 2, here also 0, 27 plus 51, 78, minus 72 plus 33, is minus 39. 4, 17, 11. Now if we take minus 39 common from this row 2, and minus 2 common from row 1, or 2 common from row 1. So 2 common from row 1 and 39 common from row 2. It will give us 0, 2, minus 1, 0, 2, minus 1, 4, 17, 11. Taking 2 common from R1 and 39 common from R2. So this is equals to 0. Why? Because R1 and R2 are identical. So in this way we have to solve. Whenever the numbers are very large, our first target will be to make the numbers small, then next target will be to make maximum number of zeros, and if by bringing that, if any two rows or columns become identical, then directly we can write 0. Otherwise, if it is not coming identical, then we have to break through that column which has maximum number of 0. If here identical is not coming, then what to do? Then we have to expand it through this column. The row or column which has maximum number of 0, we have to expand through that column. Next question. Prove that A plus B plus C. Then 2A, 3A. 3A plus 2B. 4A plus 3B plus 2C. 6A plus 3B. 10A plus 6B plus 3C. This is equals to A cube. This you have to prove. So first target will be to make maximum number of zeros in any column or in any rows. That will be our target. Now check in the LHS we have this determinant A 2A 3A, A plus B, 3A plus 2B, 6A plus 3B, A plus B plus C, 4a plus 3b plus 2c, 10a plus 6b plus 3c. This we have. See, the element of second row, first element is 2a. So if we multiply 2 with first row and if we subtract from this, this will become 0. No need to look at the other element, because our target to make the elements of any one row or any one column zeros. So if we make these two zero, then the element of first row, first column, two elements will become zero. We can expand through the first element. So to make this zero is very easy. What operation we have to do? We have to do R2 minus 2R1. And to make this element 0, it is also very easy. What we have to do? We have to do R3 minus 3R1. So R1 is fixed. This will be 0. 2a plus 2b, we have to subtract from this. So 2b, 2b cancelled. 3a minus 2a, that is a. 4a minus 2a, that is 2a. 3b minus 2b, that is b. And 2c minus 2c cancelled. 3a minus 3a, 0. 3 we are multiplying with this. So 3a plus 3b, here it will be. And if we subtract from this, so 3b, 3b cancelled. 6a minus 3a, that is 3a. Similarly, 10a minus 3a, that is 7a. 6b minus 3b, that is 3b. And 3c minus 3c cancelled. So this we have. Now, either we can simplify it or directly we can break it. We can expand it by first column. But here we can simplify it more. How? Because if we multiply 3 with this and if we subtract from this, it will be more simplified. So R3 we are changing by R3 minus 3R2. Here it will be 0. 3 we are multiplying to this. 6a, 7a minus 6a, that is a. 3b minus 3b cancelled, so a left here. Now we can expand along first column. So a into a, 2a plus b, 0a. If we take this element, so first row and first column we have to delete, and whatever left we have to write under determinant sign. So this we have. What we have done? Expanding along C1. So this is equals to A into a square minus 2a minus 2a plus b into 0. So that is a into a square is equals to a cube equals to RHS. Proved. Is it clear? Okay, now move to the next problem. This question is very much important. Next question, question number 3. Prove that minus a square AB AC ए बी माइनस बी स्क्वायर बी सी ए सी बी सी माइनस सी स्क्वायर दिस इज इक्वल्स टू फोर ए स्क्वायर बी स्क्वायर सी स्क्वायर दिस वी हैव टू प्रूफ. Now check, easily we can take A common from the first row, B common from the second row and C common from the third row. Or we can take A common from the first column, B common from the second column, C common from the third column. Anything we can do. So LHS minus A square AB AC AB minus B square BC AC BC minus C square. This is equals to ABC. A we have taken common from the first column. So if we take common from the first column, here we have A, here we have B, here we have C. If we take B common from the second column, here we have A, here we have minus B, here we have C. If we take in common C from the third column, so here we have A, here we have B, here we have minus C. What we have done? Taking A, B, C common from C1, C2, C3 respectively. Now see, next what we have to do, if we do C2, if we are changing C2 plus C1, then it will become 0, and C3 plus C1, so this will become 0, then we can expand. So C2 we are changing C2 plus C1, and C3 we are changing C3 plus C1. It is ABC. C1 fixed, it will be 0, this is also 0, this is 2C, this is 0, this is 2B, this is 0. Now easily we can expand along first column, so ABC minus A into 0, 2B, 2C, 0, expanding along R1. So this is equals to ABC minus A 0 into 0, 0 minus 2B into 2C, that is 4BC, and here minus and minus it will become plus, so 4 A square, B square, C square. This is equals to RHS. Understood? In each and every problem, first we have to see whether we can take common anything or not. Then our target will be to make maximum number of zeros either in any rows or in any columns. That will be the target. Next problem, question number 4, this is also very important problem. Prove that determinant alpha alpha square beta plus gamma beta beta square gamma plus alpha gamma gamma square alpha plus beta, this is equals to alpha minus beta into beta minus gamma into gamma minus alpha into alpha plus beta plus gamma. This we have to prove. Now check here. In this row alpha is there, and in the third row beta plus gamma is there. Alpha is missing. So if we add R1 and R3, here we will get alpha plus beta plus gamma. Similarly, here beta is missing. So here also alpha plus beta plus gamma we have. Here also alpha plus beta plus gamma we have. So in this way, if we make all the three elements alpha plus beta plus gamma, we can take it common. So what we have to do? LHS alpha beta gamma, alpha square beta square gamma square, beta plus gamma, gamma plus alpha, and alpha plus beta. Here we have to apply R3, we are changing by R3 plus R1, so that alpha beta gamma alpha square beta square gamma square, and here alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha plus beta plus gamma. This we have. Now we can take alpha plus beta plus gamma, we can take common. So if we take alpha plus beta plus gamma common, what we have? Alpha beta gamma alpha square beta square gamma square 1 1 1, alpha plus beta plus gamma taken common from R3. This we have. Now what will be our next target? To make maximum zeros, easily we can make this one. We can make 0, C1 minus C3, C2 minus C3, because all these elements are equal. So here we will apply C1 minus C3 and C2 minus C3. Alpha plus beta plus gamma. So here we have alpha minus beta, alpha minus gamma, alpha square minus gamma square 0. Beta minus gamma, beta square minus gamma square 0, gamma, gamma square 1. Next, what we have to do? Next, we can break it. A square minus B square formula. So here we will get alpha minus gamma into alpha plus gamma. Here we will get beta minus gamma into beta plus gamma. So we can take alpha minus gamma common from the first column, beta minus gamma common from the second column. So alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha minus gamma if we take common from the first column, and beta minus gamma if we take common from the second column, here what we left? 1. Here alpha plus gamma 0, here 1, here beta plus gamma 0, gamma, gamma square 1. What we have done? Taking alpha minus gamma and beta minus gamma common from C1 and C2 respectively. Now we can expand it. Now we can expand it by R3. So if we expand R3, what is this element? Sine of this element, 3 3 element is plus. So 1 into, we have to delete this column and this row. So this will left 1 1 alpha plus gamma beta plus gamma. So now expanding along R3, we have alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha minus gamma, beta minus gamma into 1 into 1 1 alpha plus gamma beta plus gamma. This we have. That is alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha minus gamma, beta minus gamma into beta plus gamma minus alpha minus gamma. So gamma gamma cancel. So therefore we have alpha plus beta plus gamma into alpha minus gamma into beta minus gamma into beta minus alpha. Now in the proof we have alpha minus beta and gamma minus alpha. So if we change, take common minus from here and minus common from here, both will become plus. So easily we can write this is equals to alpha minus beta, beta minus gamma, gamma minus alpha, alpha plus beta plus gamma equals to RHS. Proved. The last problem, question number 5. Here we have to show that determinant of a plus x, 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 y, a plus y, y, z, z, a plus z, this is equals to a square into a plus x plus y plus z. So here LHS we have a plus x, 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 y, a plus y, y, z, z, a plus z. Now check, if we add all these, or if we add all these, what we have? A plus x plus y plus z. Here also x plus a plus y plus z. Here also x plus y plus a plus z. It will come. So what we have to do? C1, if we are changing C1 plus C2 plus C3, we have, see, if we add row wise, then what we have? A plus 3x, a plus 3y, a plus 3z, all are different, we cannot take common. But if we add column wise, then in all the column a plus x plus y plus z it is coming, a plus x plus y plus z, a plus x plus y plus z, and that is our target. If all the elements of a column are same, we can take it common. Now we can take it common. So a plus x plus y plus z, if we take common 1 1 1, y a plus y y, z z, a plus z, and this RHS also helps us. In the RHS, just check a plus x plus y plus z is there. So from this also, you can understand that this element you can take common. So first we have to try to make whether this is coming or not. In the previous question also, see, alpha plus beta plus gamma was there, so that's why we are trying to make this element inside the determinant so that we can take common. Now easily if we apply R2 minus R1 and R3 minus R1, 0 0 will be there. So here we are applying R2 minus R1 and R3 minus R1. Therefore we have a plus x plus y plus z, 1 y z, 0 a 0, 0 0 a. Now expanding through first column, if we expand through first column, what we have? This row and this column of, so determinant of a 0 0 a, that is a square will be there. So ultimately a square into a plus x plus y plus z, it is coming, expanding along C1. Proved. So in this way we have to solve the questions of determinant. In our next class we will solve few more questions. Okay. Thank you students. Have a nice day.